In lots of ways, he's a great, unbelievable. Probably one of the strongest men I've ever met in my life, sort of above the waist. I had the unfortunate experience of playing against him a few times. I was honoured to play with him when I was about 18 years old. He was in his prime. We came over to Hull County for the first meeting, and we've been friends ever since. It's been roller coaster ride, excellent.
He's one of those players who never ever took a backward step, did he? And he's renowned for that.
Just a complete player. You know, he was a great defender, he was a tough, great ball player, runner, did everything. The game was specialised a bit more than that. But he could do anything you asked him.
When you look at the size of him as well, you find out where he actually started off as a halfback. It's unbelievable to think though, isn't it?
Well, I didn't know he was a halfback. He always played in the second row when I played with him. Just in front row, latterly. But he was... a great all-round player. That's a good ball player. Could have done anything he wanted to do apart from kick if you asked Dennis Harley. Because Dennis, in the 1970 test matches, charged a kick down from Arthur and scored. So it was I don't think Arthur ever kicked again, to be honest, after that.
He's a bit of a reputation off the pitch for lacking his food as well, which he's told us is a bit of a myth, but it goes before him, that one, doesn't it, really?
It's no myth, I can assure you. I mean, when I was a young man, I could eat plenty and he beat me hand down. Dare fall asleep at the table in case he ate you, which is a fact. Got to be as bad as that.
And the figures as well, you played, as you say, at Hull KR, and what a great personality to come over and enjoy the game in, and for us to enjoy him as well at that era.
Yes, I think people coming over from Australia to us was unusual, to say the least. The circumstances brought him over by a Colin Hutton, actually. And it was great. I came up with a fellow, another good friend of mine, Jim Paul, who was well known in Australian blue circles, and we're still good friends. If I go over, I'll go and see them both, and go and get drunk as these people do.
Because you played with him here, and you played against him when you went over to Manly as well in Australia. How was he held? What regard was he held in during those days?
He was probably the best forward in the competition at the time I was there, and he played for Manly for 3 years. He obviously was before and after that, but he was awesome, absolutely awesome. Great fella, seriously. Both on and off the pitch, really. It was some great times.
That's it, big man, big personality. That's excellent. Thanks very much, Bill. I really appreciate it.
My pleasure, thank you.